Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome to Farming Simulator 2017. Today we have a very cool mod. This is a very well done mod. Got a lot of options to choose from in the store. And while I'm saying well done, let's see this. Okay, that's not great, but small thing. We can live with it. Anyways, this is a 2007. Ooh, what are the years? 2003 to 2007? I think it is. That's where the body style is. Body style is. I'm not completely sure. I can't remember. Anyways. Yeah. So, get a lot of options on this truck. This is the, this is the one that has a stock bumper on it. Get a ton of options. So you can get one with a stock bumper. Or you can get one with the ranching bumper. And you can get sidesteps. Or no sidesteps. You can also get single rear wheel. Or dual rear wheel like I have on this one. I like the look of the dual better. This one I didn't get. This one I got the single rear wheel. But I liked it better because it was in the black. That matches my truck. My truck in real life. Because I have like my bar across, my truck is all black, everything's blacked out. I like the mud flaps too. Those are cool little Chevy boat tail. So overall, this truck, I mean, I honestly love this body style Chevy. My next truck will definitely be a Duramax like this. Probably not with a bet on it like this, but it'll definitely be a 2003-2007 body style truck with the Duramax, probably 2500 crew cab. Probably one of the shorter, probably the medium sized box. Because, I mean, the 8-foot box, those things are just a little too big for me. But, anyways, we're talking farm simulator. Anyways, we got this PJ 40-foot trailer here. It's a bit much for this test, but I couldn't find the other one I had that actually worked good. I need to find a good computer trailer at the gooseneck. But anyway, let's start it up. I did modify this truck a little bit, I should say. The exhaust was originally in front of the wheel. I did not like that, so I put it behind the wheel, and I made it blow smoke. I thought it was only fitting. Got an interesting camera here. That's the interior camera. Kind of screwed up. Interior looks like crap. Anyways. They made it look pretty from the outside, I should say. So. It's got lights all around. It's pretty nice. It's got a lot. This truck's not good with tongue weight. Suspension needs a bit of work, but if you're just driving around as a show truck, then I guess that'll work good for you. Because this truck is really, really got the back pushed down real good. Anyways, turn these lights off. Anyways, it'll tow around your stuff. It'll blow smoke. It's pretty cool. Big old tow mirrors. I love this body style. Maybe 2005. Maybe that's all good. I don't know. These trucks aren't really expensive. It's just hard to find one in good condition. Another thing I'll show you later on this truck is it's lifted, obviously. So, if you try and hook anything to the hitch back there, it's gonna be like really far off the ground. So, the back of the trailer will probably drag. This doesn't have the best engine sounds. It just kind of sounds like it doesn't really have a 40-something, which kind of sounds like a mile. Even if you're driving at, you know, speed up, just going at wilderness. That's pretty awesome. Just blowing smoke. God damn, my video thumbnail right there. Got ourselves a New Holland drive drum there. This is definitely a farm truck right here. Or I guess if you were doing some hot shot hauling, you can use it for that too. Let's park this truck. Once we disconnect it, level, squats right down. Like this truck, I was telling you. This truck's not squatting too much in the back, both of the trailer. It's like, yeah. Back, I thought the bag was originally dragging, it's not, but this truck looks cool too. I like the white and black. I know somebody with a truck like this. He's got 2500 with the, except everything's white, but he has black wheels. It's awesome. Okay, the mirrors, you can see through the mirrors, that's kind of cheesy. A ton of people worked on this truck, and I would have thought they'd be able to fix some of the oil things, but I guess not. Lights are cool. I was debating on putting a stack on. I thought a stack wouldn't look very good. I'll just slam into that. I thought a stack wouldn't look very good with this bed. So that's why I went the exhaust at the back. Anyways, there's another Nomax. We'll compare it to that one. This is the one that I did over here. The one that I made. This one has the stack. I don't really like the stack anymore. I thought it was a good idea at first, but I don't know if I like it anymore. As you can see, my model. Okay, one thing is all farm sim models aren't going to scale. Like mine's a little definitely wider. I'm not sure which one is correct. Hi there. But you can see that mine's obviously a little bit wider. Like I said, I don't know which one's correct, but I didn't throw any New York plates on this, because whatever. But
hi there.
Stop saying hi there. But yeah, they got, you got the white chimney. I like my truck, but I mean, I didn't do the best job on it. Still a good truck, but I just. I don't know. I think something that's got a lot better, or this one has a lot better aero bay and a lot better detail, a lot more detail. Like on this one, rail is literally just a texture. I think. I can't remember. I think the headlights, those are really chill. These are pretty good over here. But the fender flares aren't greatest, but. Anyways, there's a little comparison to my truck. You can see the mirrors. This one obviously is, has the bed on it still. Anyways, hopefully I like this video. Kind of a long video, but I thought this truck deserved it. This truck was really nice. But anyways, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.